Hello, my name is Mihail Petrov, and today I'm gonna cook for you a vegetable Wellington with a sous vide carrot, celeriac infused with hay puree, and a beautiful demi-glace sauce. You'll need cauliflower, onion, mushroom, celeriac, carrot, eggplant, garlic, a little bit of olive oil, tomato paste, and stock. Mix it. Just drizzle a little bit of olive oil so the vegetables don't stick to the cooking pan. Mix them nicely. Put some black pepper. Some salt. We cook them for 35 minutes on 150 degrees. So now we continue with the mushrooms. For the mushrooms, you will need mushrooms, some fresh thyme, some garlic, and some shallot. So we're going to blitz all together. Some salt and pepper. Mushrooms in a non-fatted pan. Just cook it until all the water has dissolved from the mushroom. Turn the heat a little bit. Now we can continue with the celeriac puree. First we have to infuse the hay cream with the hay. Heat it up a little bit. So, this is a hay that I baked at 170 degrees for 10 minutes, so it goes really well. It's fragrance, it's just combo. We put the hay inside, we have to turn it to a boil. And for the demi-glace, I use those products because they have a lot of natural sugars that make the demi-glace thicker and really tasty. Here I have my pans in which I'm gonna cook the vegetables for the Wellington. In the pan on the bottom, I have hay, star anise, cloves, some juniper berry, bay leaves, pepper mix, so it has that spiciness. For the inside of the Wellington, I'm gonna use celeriac, carrots, sweet potatoes, and I'm gonna saute baby spinach with some walnuts, because the walnuts are really good protein. And in another pan, I'm gonna saute the onion. So, I just need to put some stock in the pans. That's a basic vegetable stock that I made earlier today from carrot skins, parsley, stems, thyme stems, celeriac peels. So we put them up. It doesn't go away for the 45 minute period that we bake the vegetables. And then with this. Okay, the cream is starting to boil. And now we put some lentil let the cream to infuse. You have to dry really nice the mushroom and don't want any excess water. So here I have the trays with the hay and we put some parchment paper on top. Then spread the produce. So we have to wrap them up with aluminium foil so they steam out in the oven. And keep them for later when we roll the vegetable Wellington. That's so they cook more evenly. Now we're waiting for the vegetables to cook so we can put the stock inside with the tomato paste. And we're gonna get them back in the oven for about 30 more minutes. And then we're gonna make the puree when the cream is infused. And we're gonna cook the vegetables when we put the stock on this one. And for the last, I will have to sous vide the carrot with some of the sauce, then glaze. So now, here are the cooked vegetables for the vegetable demi-glace. And now, after they have cooked 35 minutes, we pull in the vegetable stock with the tomato puree. A homemade tomato puree. Now we mix it and we will get to cook it for another about 30 minutes. We also cook the other vegetables for the wedding. They had to cook as well for 30 to 40 minutes. So now heavy cream has cooled down and we can pass it through a fine sieve. Now we put the celeriac inside. When it goes to a boil, we are gonna lower the heat so it turns to a rolling boil. And the celeriac is gonna be ready when it's nice and tender. Then we're gonna blitz the celeriac with a little bit of the infused cream and pass it through a fine sieve so we get beautiful infused puree. So now the vegetables for the vegetable demi-glace have cooked through and we're gonna sieve them. We want all the juice from the vegetables inside, so we crush them a little bit. Now all the flavors are in the bowl, so we get them out. We're gonna reduce the sauce by half. And we're gonna use just a bit of the sauce for the carrot sous vide. And the carrot, we're just gonna peel it so it has the beautiful rectangular shape. We just place it in the bag. And when the sauce is ready, we're gonna vacuum it with the sauce. So now we have rolled out our pastry, we have our egg wash, and now we're gonna saute the spinach and the onion. It's not sauteing, I think it's blanching. because I'm gonna make it with some vegetables, but so it doesn't have some fats. Meanwhile, we're cooking the puree and we're reducing the sauce. We heat up some stuff. We're just gonna blanch it. The pepper. Drizzle of olive oil. So now we're gonna drain the excess water. And mix it with the walnuts. You'll just get a light color on the onion. So now the onion is cooked, it has a bit of color. We set it aside for the rolling of the Wellington. So here are all the ingredients I need for the Wellington. The sauce is still reducing. The celeriac is tender. But we're gonna make the puree after we throw the Wellington. So we start with the mushrooms. Start by spreading the mushrooms all over the pastry, but I'm leaving the top part, all the ends, so I can seal up the Wellington. Now on top, we put the spinach with the walnut, spreading it nicely so every bite of the Wellington has a bit of spinach. Next, we put the onion. Again, spreading them nicely. Now, here are vegetables that we have cooked with the hay and the spices, and the fragrance is just immaculate. We want it to layer evenly because the more evenly layered, the more even it will roll. Sides of the pastry so it closes nicely. I should have done this before I closed the Wellington, just a rookie mistake. Making it real nice and back. And now we're gonna put it in the fridge for about from 1 hour to 6 hours so it can rest. So now this is the celeriac that has been cooked. We're gonna blitz it in the mixer with just a little bit of the heavy cream, just a little bit of cream. So it has no lumps. So now we put a bit of that beautiful vegetable demi-glace in the vacuum bag that we're gonna put the carrot in. I don't have a sous vide. I'm gonna use my oven on 100 degrees on steam for 45 minutes. here's how it looks. I have vacuumed it with some of the sauce, so when it cooks, the sauce sucks in the carrot and gets really good cooked. For 45 minutes, precisely. This beautiful thick sauce. So now, the carrot is cooked through. We need to cool it off, so we stop the cooking process. This stops the cooking process. We get a pan, medium red, the Wellington. We're gonna bake it with the closed side down. We take the egg wash and we brush it nicely. So when it cooks, it has that beautiful color. Just so it's more beautiful, we're gonna score it. Just pass the knife like this. And now we need about 5 minutes more for the Wellington. Meanwhile, we're gonna glaze the carrot, warm up the sauce. For the glazing, we'll need a little bit of stock. We put the carrot in the stock, a bit of salt, a bit of pepper, and instead of sugar, just gonna use a little bit of honey. The sauce is nice and warm, but we're running low on gas, so we'll have to make it on the same burner. The Wellington is just ready. This is the thick demi-glace sauce that we're gonna use. Celeriac puree. And we're getting out the Wellington. It doesn't look as great as I thought it would, but it's still really good. When it comes to the boil, we're gonna put a little bit of butter inside. So let's start with the sauce. We just put the sauce in the middle. Like this. We spread it lightly with the spoon. Nice circle. Now take them off. Discard the hands. Just like that. Now we want around 3 centimeters thick piece of the Wellington. So now take this of the vegetable Wellington and put it in the middle. Being careful not splattering the sauce, just like this. Put the puree inside. So now we have to slice the carrot. Just like that. Okay. Look good. Celeriac puree. Just making small dots on top of the carrot. And this is my dish. A vegetable Wellington with a sous vide carrot, he infused celeriac puree and a vegetable demi-glace.